Hello, my dear students of class 6. Welcome to our English class. Today, we will be beginning a new session with our English again. We have covered some lessons, and then today will be a new session. And the story that we are going to discuss about today is the banyan tree. And I'm Vivekunyo Ville from Mount Sinai High Secondary School. Okay, the banyan tree. Have you heard of the banyan tree, or have you even seen with your eyes? Some of you might have seen this tree. Some of you may not be aware of what this tree is. But I'm going to explain in the later course of our class of how and what a banyan tree is. Okay? And you will find that in page number 125. Okay? Page number 125 of your textbook, you will find this chapter. And this is lesson number 10. I repeat, lesson number 10. And you will find that in page number 125. Okay, after discussing the story and after going through the story, the things that you are going to learn is you will learn to read the story with fluency. You know what is fluency, right? Without reluctance or without stopping. Sometimes if you are reading a new language, you find it difficult, right? You find it difficult to go through with fluency. But when it is English, I know you all are fluent with your readings right now. Okay, we will also learn some new words, okay? You will also learn some new words as well as learn to understand about the animal world. Sometimes we are so focused in our own human world that we tend to miss out the things, the interesting things that we see even in the animal world. So we are going to discuss mostly about animals. And remember, we have a friend here in this story, okay? When I say a friend, the author as a boy, okay? The author means the person who wrote the story. It is written by Ruskin Bond. And we are going to see how the little boy, okay, he is not so little, but a boy of around 10, 11 years. He might even be the age of, for like some of you, okay? So we are going to discuss about how this little boy experiences something new on a banyan tree. And you will even be able to answer simple questions after reading the story. You go through the story. There are times that you need the help of your teachers. You need the help of your seniors and elders. But after going through this story and listening to this explanation, I'm sure you all will be able to answer the simple questions that are going to be given at the back. Or you can even frame your own questions. That is how you learn better, okay? Not just sticking to the answers that your teachers might have given you, but it is also wise and good to experience yourself mentally, okay? By answering some questions, or you can even ask questions to one another. That is what I want you to do after listening to this explanation as well as after going through the textbook. Some word meanings, as usual, we have always been learning about word meanings, right? We are also going to learn about some new words again, which you will come across the story. I've always been focusing on you learning new words. By now, you might be aware that you are going to learn some new words before the start of every lesson. So today, some new words that we are going to learn is, look at this. This means spy, watch secretly. Repeat, spy. Watch secretly, resent, dislike, feel angry about, dislike or feel angry about, during the fig season, the time when figs appeared. During the fig season, the time when figs appeared. Propping myself up, leaning against. Propping myself up means leaning against, grandstand view. A clear view from the best position. Grandstand view. A clear view from the best position. Gliding. Moving smoothly. Gliding. Moving smoothly. Clump. A group. A clump means a group of bushes or trees. Here in this story, we are also going to see some clumps of bushes and trees. Later, you will see that some animals will be needing these clumps of bushes and trees in order to have protection. Okay? And the next word here comes emerged. Came out. Emerged. Came out. Clearing. An open space in a forest where there are no trees. Repeat. An open space in a forest where there are no trees. Sex. A part of an animal or plant shaped like a bag. a part of an animal or plant shaped like a bag. Fangs, long sharp teeth of a snake or a dog. Fangs, long sharp teeth of a snake or a dog. Okay, yes, this is a banyan tree. You see here in the picture that we can see a banyan tree. This is a banyan tree. And the special thing about a banyan tree that is that it can sprout out new branches. And from the branches, the roots will hang down. You can see the roots hanging down from the trees here, right? All these branches will get down to the ground. And as soon as they touch the ground, they will sprout out new plants of banyan trees. Have you ever heard that a banyan tree can turn into a forest? A single banyan tree can turn into a forest. Why? Because from every branch, there will be some roots hanging down. And when these roots touches the ground, new plants will sprout out. That is why a banyan is considered to be a tree that can become a forest on its own. We have also heard that a tree cannot be a forest of its own, but when it comes to the case of a banyan tree, it is not like that. It can make a forest out of a single tree, okay? And why the banyan tree is important here is our friend. I told you we are going to have a friend, right? Our friend, that is the boy, okay? The boy is going to use this banyan tree as a grandstand view. We have come across the word meaning, the new words, a grandstand view means a place where you have a good view of things. If you buy a ticket to go and watch a sport, okay, or a movie, the best place that is the grandstand view will be the most expensive tickets, right? And so we are going to see that the young boy is going to use this banyan tree as a grandstand view. And the story starts like this. The boy and his grandfather. We all want to visit our grandparents, isn't it? You want to visit your grandmother, your grandfather, because of so many reasons that I'm not going to explain everything today. By now, you got the reason why you want to visit your grandparents, right? And here, the boy will go to his grandparents' house, and then the grandfather is 65 years old. No, that grandfather would also be the age like your grandfather, isn't it? So you can picture yourself as the young boy and your grandfather as the grandfather of the boy. And so they lived in Dehradun. Dehradun is the name of a city or is the name of a town, right? And so they lived in Dehradun. The house in front of the banyan tree belongs to his grandfather. As a young boy, he will not be having a house on his own because he had not started earning. But the grandfather had a big house, and in front of the house stands a banyan tree. Okay, a banyan tree. And the boy considers the banyan tree to be his, though the house belongs to his grandfather. There are some things that belongs to other, but you use it more, isn't it? And so it's almost like that belongs to you. And so the boy used to feel he had a sense of belongingness, okay? He feels that the banyan tree belongs to him, though the house belongs to his grandfather. And then he loves to sit on the tree. I repeat, he loves to sit on the banyan tree. There are so many reasons why you will see that the boy would love to sit on the banyan tree. On a warm summer day, he would also go and sit there. He would spend his time there. Whenever he does not want to do anything at home, he would take the cushion. Okay, he would take the cushion from the living room, and he had already made a platform for himself, right? He had made a crude platform for himself, and he would be sitting there. And then one very interesting thing about the banyan tree is there will be the spreading of branches. I've already told you, right? I've already told you that the branches of banyans will hang down the roots and it will bring another new tree. That's what we have discussed. And so there will be spreading branches, and it is such a sight, okay? It is such a beautiful sight to see the banyan tree spreading out its branches, and there will be twisting passages, and he can walk, okay? He can walk between the branches. When new plant starts, he cannot just walk straight. By now, I'm sure you will be able to understand that. There will be some twisting passages among the trees. And even on the tree, when he is already there, there will be some twisting passages. I'm sure he will not just be sitting on one place, because that would become boring for you as well as for me too. And the young boy is a boy of your age, so I'm sure he would love to go to another branch, and then he would sit there and watch things, right? And so there are some other creatures that makes it more exciting. He can see the snails and the butterflies. You see the pictures here, right? This is the picture of a snail, and this is the picture of a butterfly, and this is a squirrel with nuts, isn't it? And so the boy loves to see all these things. It is not only about the tree, the branches, and the twisting passages, but there are so many creatures that comes to the banyan tree. And some, to name a few, as we see the picture here, there will be snails, there will be butterflies, squirrels. I think that makes it more interesting for a young boy, isn't it? We would all love to see this kind of creatures around our house. And I'm sure you all love butterflies flying around, and that gives you a sight of excitement, joy, and happiness. And then here is a friendship that is going to be built between the boy and the squirrel. Okay, initially, that means at first, the squirrel disapproves. He did not like the boy coming to the tree. And as normal, all animals, almost all animals do not like human beings because they fear, they're scared that animals will be killed. These animals will be killed by human beings. So there is a gray squirrel. And the boy loves the gray squirrel so much, but the squirrel was scared, afraid. Scared means afraid, okay? The squirrel was afraid, and he did not like the boy coming to the banyan tree because that is originally his house. Human beings live in a house, and for squirrels and birds, they live on the trees, isn't it? And so the squirrel did not like the boy coming. But later, you will see that they become friends, okay? They are going to become friends. The squirrel noticed, okay? The squirrel saw that there are no catapults or air guns in the boy's hands, so he found it a little safe. Because even animals know that when a person has these weapons and arms, they can be killed at any time. Though he was scared at first, finally finding out that the boy was not armed with all these weapons, the squirrel began to get close to the boy, and later the boy will give him, okay, cakes and biscuits and the sweets that he eat, okay? And he will give, the squirrel might be reluctant at first to take all these things, but finding that the boy is harmless, that the boy is not going to do any harm to him, the squirrel and the boy became very good friends. They became good friends, they would share, and at first the squirrel was reluctant, I told you that, but later on, even before the boy gives out these cakes and biscuits, what does the squirrel do? He would just come and search in the boy's pockets, okay? He would just come and search in the boy's pockets and look whether he has anything to offer to him or not, okay? So that was the beautiful friendship that was created on the banyan tree. And one more thing, friends and relatives of the squirrel considered him foolish to trust humans. If you are going to befriend a tiger, maybe your parents will not allow that because your parents are scared that the tiger would one day eat you up. And also the same thing with animals. They are also scared of human beings. When they found that the gray squirrel and the young boy had become very good friends, what did they say? They say they might have said so many things to the squirrel at home, isn't it? Sometimes when you go out with a friend who is naughty or who is not very good or who is very disobedient to their parents and teachers, I'm sure your parents tell you not to go out with those kind of friends. So also the same thing with animals. They're saying that he should not go with the boy because human beings may harm them anytime. But he began to trust. And the boy had won the trust and the heart of the squirrel. So they were very close. They would love to spend their day, every single day together on the banyan tree. Now, the parents and relatives of the squirrel had nothing to say, but they just say that it is foolish of the squirrel to trust human beings because they're still expecting that the boy would kill the squirrel one day or harm the squirrel one day. This is the squirrel that we are talking about, okay? A gray squirrel, and the parents did not want them to get close because they knew very well that human beings are capable of hunting animals, okay? And during the spring season, there will be red figs on the banyan tree. Every tree bears fruit, almost every tree bears fruit. And when a tree bears fruit, it attracts a lot of animals. We all know that. You might have seen cherry trees in your compound, or even in Nagaland, we have a lot of cherry trees, right? So when the cherries are blooming, you will see that the birds will fill the trees, and it is such a beautiful sight. And more when the cherry starts bearing fruit, isn't it? So in spring season, when the banyan tree starts bearing figs, what happens is all kinds of birds would come to eat the figs. All kinds of birds would come to eat the figs, and the banyan tree becomes the noisiest place in the garden. There will be so many trees, but the banyan tree becomes the noisiest place because the parrots, mynas, crows, and the red-bottom bulbul. This is a red-bottom bulbul. Okay, the picture that you see here is a red-bottom bulbul. And there will be so many birds that would come and eat the figs of the banyan. And everything becomes very noisy, and it becomes more interesting for the boy to have a look at all these things. The boy would just sit on the banyan tree, and he would make a platform. Okay, I told you that he had already built a place for himself to sit there and watch things. And it is not just to watch things, but he would take his favorite books. Treasure Island is a book I would also recommend you to read. It is a very interesting book. Okay, Treasure Island, the Huckleberry Finn. All these are some books that the boy would love to read on the banyan tree. Okay, and then sometimes when he is lazy to read, we all feel lazy sometimes, doing the same thing over and over again, isn't it? So he would just look down through the leaves of the banyan tree, and he would have a very good view. We discussed about the grandstand view, isn't it? From the grandstand view, because he considers that the banyan tree is the best place to look at things of what is happening beneath. Beneath means under, okay? And then one day he saw a mongoose and a cobra. Okay, he saw a mongoose and a cobra. It was a warm day. It's hot, okay? So everyone went home. Even the gardener did not want to work there. So he went home. Everyone went indoor. But two superb fighters, that means two very good fighters, came face to face. Who are they? That is the mongoose and the cobra, okay? The mongoose and the cobra came out. And he was watching at how things would be. If you have not seen a mongoose, this is a picture of a mongoose and this is a cobra. And so he was wondering what these two creatures would do. So he was just quietly looking at it. The two fighters did not notice him. Okay, the two fighters did not notice him. And then the battle began. See, this is the battle of the mongoose and the cobra. Okay, the mongoose is a very quick animal. The cobra is slow. But the mongoose knew very well that the venom, that means the poison that comes out from the cobra, is very poisonous. So he had to escape it anytime. Here you see the venom of the cobra being thrown out at the mongoose. But the mongoose is always very quick and very wise to escape that. Okay, there, as I told you, both were super fighters. Mongoose cannot stand the venom, that means the poison that comes out of the cobra's mouth. And the cobra knew very well that mongoose is very quick in his moves. The two combatants. Combatants mean the participants in the fight. We're unaware of the silent spectator. That means they do not know that the boy was watching over them from the tree. Okay. And we are going to continue the second half of the story in our next class. I want you to be present because we are going to discuss about the battle. And there we will see more spectators and supporters too. Like human beings, when one of your friends is playing, what do? You want to cheer them up and you want to support them by doing something, isn't it? So when these two creatures, the mongoose and the cobra, starts fighting, we are also going to see some new creatures that would come and be spectators as well as try to help one of them. I'm just going to keep that in suspense. If you want to know more about the story, you have to attend our next class. Okay, so be there next class. Thank you so much for listening to this explanation. We will continue in the next class as mentioned.